Hi, my name's Charles Vandagriff, aka Spencer, Spencer's Artworks. I just wanted to take a few minutes to show you all the work that I've been working on for the past, I'd say 8 or 10 years. And these are the art pieces that I have kept. I have sold 380 of my paintings. I've done over 440 of them, and I've kept probably 15. I'm a blue collar worker, just like everybody else that is, you know, works for a living, have a family, a wife, animals. And my passion is my artwork. And it's my drawings, my graphite sketchings, my pencil sketchings, ink sketchings, colored pencil, some acrylic, and mostly acrylic, actually. And some watercolor, very small watercolor and charcoal. But welcome to my lair. And this is Dagobah. It's something my wife has always been fascinated with. Dagobah, I put a happy spin on it, kind of a silly looking comedy vibe, more of a hippie feel. Behind it is the old Dagobah trees and the swampy look. It's got that log that's across the swamp sitting there in the bottom. And this is done on a window in the home that I live in. In this video, just to give you a feel of what I've done, is as Spencer's drawings and artworks on 2023 and beyond, basically. And this is the first piece. Hippie feel to it. It's got like a Grateful Dead feel to it. I really like it. It took me about 4 weeks on and off in between 40-hour work weeks, of course. And this is the second piece from my portfolio I'm putting together. And it's basically the skull is me, the butterfly is my wife, Megan. And then it's incorporating the four winds and four elements. An animated novel, which is over 800 pieces of my work. I've been working on it for 2 years, and it's called Edgewater. The cover of the book, which will be published probably in a few years, kind of put together, and there's this. I really like it. It kind of gave it that, like, I don't know, seascape look. This is another piece that I just kind of just threw together, just something I thought would be decent. It is a third piece of what I call Desert Serenity. And I've got it on TikTok and Instagram and a few other places. But it's just something I came together. I was in the military, so I kind of put that little airborne feel to it with the an old Ranger type feel. We're going to go inside now, and we're going to take a look at the pieces that I have on the wall, and we'll go from there. Hi, welcome to the second piece of my artworks that are inside. I haven't sold any of these. These are pretty sacred to me and my family, mostly me, of course. And this is one of the first pieces I ever did. Sell this to a client, but they decided, no, they didn't want it, but I loved the way it worked out. Their daughter loved Hello Kitty. So I did a Hello Kitty, and the other daughter loved Minnie Mouse. So I did a Minnie Mouse, and I combined it in there. The son was a big fan of Transformers, so I put that together. Their names were going to be incorporated on it. They didn't want the painting because it was too expensive. I was going to sell it for $300. They said it was too expensive, so I kept it. This piece over here, this is something that I did because I'm a big fan of Pirates of the Caribbean. I just kind of threw the Black Pearl in there and just kind of put it a silhouette in the background. And you see Johnny Depp back there as Jack Sparrow, and kind of a little macabre with the skull and that I don't know, wind and rain type feel in the ocean with when the Black Pearl was doing its thing. Last piece that I just finished, this is called Your Psychology Matters. Your Psychology Matters. It's YPM. It's for a friend of mine named Gary Lowe, and it's for his podcast. It took me from concept to finished, I would say almost a year in between 40-hour work weeks and 30 plus paintings. So That's the finished piece. I don't usually do Renaissance, but this is something that I put together. I hope you like it. It was a bear to work on. It was a lot of work, a lot of detail, extremely macabre, and gave it kind of an old 17th, 16th century feel to it. Now we're gonna go into the other room so I can show you the final pieces that I have, that I've kept for my family and myself. This is the final part of what I've kept as far as my artworks. I'm a big fan of the old Looney Tunes and Bugs Bunny type feel. This right here was from like the Bugs Bunny feel, where they had the little witch that would chase Bugs Bunny, and she had a little witch's house and everything. But I didn't put the witch's house in there. I just loved the colors I picked out. And I put the old tree in there with the moon, and it gave it kind of an old Halloween type feel. And then there's one of my favorites right there, which I've never sold and never will sell. I'm a huge Star Wars fan. This is all the characters that I kind of just put together. It is Yoda, Darth Vader, Boba Fett. This piece is from Victoria Herbert, and she put this together for Megan Maxwell. And if you don't know anything about it, then look it up, because it has to go with this piece, which is part of the Triple Goddess. And this is the Triple Goddess over here that she put together, and she delivered that to Megan Maxwell a few years ago. As far as we have the candles, the candelabra type feel, macabre feel. I did this last Halloween. I found this picture. I love the frame. It looked like an old house type feel. I put my own colors in it with the skull coming out of the frame, because I kind of like that Halloween feel. That's just me. Huge fan of Magic the Gathering. This is a necromancer from Magic the Gathering. I'll never sell it. It's a very small piece, but it's super detailed. I personally love it. And then my roommate's daughter did this, which is Lana Del Rey. And she's a major fan of Lana Del Rey. And if you don't know anything about her, Google her, and you'll understand more. And it is Harley Quinn. I threw it together in a few days, and I like it, and it kind of incorporates how her mindset is sometimes, and everybody has their own personality. This is from Sleepy Hollow, and that is the Tree of the Dead. I'll never sell it. I never wanted to sell it. It's because I'm a huge Tim Burton fan. That is the second piece on the bottom underneath there, and that is the windmill from Sleepy Hollow as well. Is from Clash of the Titans. It's a redo of Clash of the Titans. I put and incorporated all the different movies from Clash of the Titans, and I threw what they call Medusa's Lair in there, which is basically a stone lair with a stone lake in the deep winter. Medusa is over here. She's shooting the arrows into all of the Minotaur and all the bodies that have basically been consumed by this damn abyss that just kind of just engulfed everybody. This piece on the bottom down here, this is called Rebirth. In 2020 and 21, we had a pandemic, and it was horrible for everybody. It was nationwide, worldwide, everything. This is how I felt about it. This is the yin yang, and it represents the good and the bad. And that is the coronavirus. And that is a detailed microscopic version of the coronavirus that I thought would incorporate into what our earth was like, burning from the inside out. I did not really understand what was going on as much as some people did. I didn't want to get into real detail, so I put it on paper and I put it on canvas, because that's how I felt. I felt like we were just in a survival mode, and that's it. Together by Lael. And she's actually the one that's editing this. She wanted to just kind of throw something together with her feel on it. This is my first ever airbrush, and my wife is a huge fan of Spyro the Dragon, the video game. She loves Spyro the Dragon. Messing around with airbrush. This is the second piece I ever did with airbrush. I will not do any more airbrushes till after I start my animated novel. It's the second piece of Dagobah, but this I wanted to put on canvas for my wife. It is Luke Skywalker and Yoda lifting up the X-Wing fighter, and then there's a silhouette of Yoda there, and there's Luke Skywalker and Yoda, and this is the background of all of the woods, the swampy background, and the planet that Yoda lives on. I'm not going to sell any more of my paintings till after 2023. All of mine are going to be now completed for my gallery and an animated novel I'm working on. Family Tree. It is a centerpiece for our grandmother, and her name was Regina Marie. We called her Riga. She's the centerpiece of all of these people that are incorporated, and each one of these vines has a family member's name on it. It's my work, and I hope you like it.
He obviously has something to say.